Hey guys, undercover and bed rug pro Kevin Stewart with the We Got You Covered post video report from the California Tournament Trail and the FLW Costa Sunglass Western Series event at Clear Lake, California from last week. I gotta tell you, I had the most incredible and memorable week at Clear Lake than I think I ever had in my life. From practice to the Saturday and Sunday two-day California Tournament Trail event onto the FLW event, I was just very, very fortunate to figure out a pattern that worked for me and a couple of groups of fish that played a key into how I finished. To start off with the California Tournament Trail last Saturday and Sunday, I found a group of fish in one very small area and managed to put in the boat just under 28 pounds on Saturday, backed it up with a little less of just under 24 pounds on Sunday to finish second in the California Tournament Trail behind the champion Wayne Brazil. And congrats, Wayne. Wayne's a very super strong competitor on that lake. To continue on, basically got one day of practice in on Tuesday prior to the FLW Costa Series event and had my five best personal day I've ever had in my life. Jumped around looking for some different areas, and it was just one of those dream days where you pull up and you catch an 8-pounder and leave it, hit a number and go to the next spot and catch a 7-pounder, hit another number and leave it. Well, it didn't work out that good on the first day of the FLW Costa Series, but I did manage to catch 26.5 pounds sitting in fifth place on Thursday. Pretty much caught my fish in two areas. One of them being the same area that I fished the 2 days in the California Tournament Trail. On Friday morning, I went to my first spot and there was a little bit too much company around. I was unable to get into my casting lane. So I ran around and really, really struggled to start catching them. But I had one more area that I had all to myself that had a large group of fish there as far as numbers wise, but the big ones didn't want to cooperate and had to really work hard to start out with probably a 6-pound five fish limit to, by the end of the day, getting it up to about 14.5 pounds. I missed a top 10 cut by a pound, dropped a 13th place finish, but after the week I had and just having basically one bad day up there and 7 days of being on the water, phenomenal week. I go to bed every night just dreaming about catching big ones now. So one thing that does not happen very often in this fishing stuff is this last week I basically had it dialed into one rod, one bait, and a few areas and grinding it out. So let's talk about what I was throwing. First off, I was throwing an iRod 723, medium heavy rod, 7'2". Got a lot of good power to it for these hook sets. The main key that I, for something that is a confidence, is this is 15 pound Seaguar and Vizex fluorocarbon. Been throwing this stuff for many, many, many years. Super confidence in it. I never broke a fish. Never broke a fish the entire week I was there. And I lost track of numbers on big ones. The main bait was a 3/8 ounce gold Blade Runner Spintrix head. It's an underspin designed by Blade Runner with a 4-inch Bastrix hollow body Spintrix trailer. This color's in Hitch. This is my confidence bait right here at Clear Lake. I believe that any shad pattern colored would work, because the fish offshore 100% were keying in on shad, and that's where I keyed in on the fish was offshore. I did try and look for them, went shallow, flipping, looking for beds, and I could find a few, but none that I thought would carry me forward. And as soon as I would make a cast with this bait offshore, I'd catch a 3 or 4 plus pounder. And I was like, well, that's where they're at. So that's where I keyed in on. I was gonna live or die by that, and it paid off as far as dividends for me. So I can't say enough about this iRod and this Seaguar and VizX line. Blade Runner, thank you for making such a great underspin in Bastrix. I had like 2 identical rods rigged up and probably 5 extra baits each day ready to go, because if I got into them real good, you know, those fish would tear them up pretty good. So I do have some people I want to thank. I want to thank my family and my friends for all their support and encouragement. Without them, you know, you can't do this, and it just keeps you going through the good times and the bad times. And my great list of sponsors, Undercover, Truck Bed Covers, you guys are amazing. Bedrug Bed Liners, I've been running this Bedrug Bed Liner for over 4 years. I love it. Tamiki Fishing Tackle, you guys know how much I love you. I wish I could have caught my fish on a Tamiki bait, but this is the bait that they wanted to eat this week. Phoenix Boats, Mercury Marine, again, thank you so much for your amazing product and the amazing customer service. Ray Marine Electronics helped me, even though I'm fishing Clear Lake shallow, and shallow being less than 12 feet deep. It was a key for me from once I left that 6 foot range and started getting into the scatter grass from 8 to 12 feet deep. What I was looking for was little slight impressions that had some sparse grass in it, and that's where I could catch these pre-spawn fish that were making their way to the bank, because that's the majority of what I caught the entire week was pre-spawners that were coming, that were moving in out from either suspended or being out deeper, getting into that 12 to 8 foot range. Power pole shallow water anchors. A few times when the wind would pick up, I would back the boat up into about 6 feet of water, drop the power poles, and then I was just able to stay right there and make multiple fan casts out to the depth that I was searching for to catch these fish. Again, iRod for making a great rod. And I'm still giddy from having the week that I had, and I really appreciate you guys taking some time with me today. You guys check out Bass Angler Headquarters. If you guys need a website built, they're doing, and they got some good stuff coming up. So check out them as well. Make sure you guys follow me at kevinstewartfishing.com. All my social media, YouTube links are right there. And guess what? Now it's time to stay home on the California Delta. So I'll see you on the river.